Here at Nielsen Norman Group, we conduct a lot of user research studies, not only to understand the usability of new design trends, but we also conduct research with our own customers to make sure our website and offerings are working for customers and our business. We recently created a database of customers willing to participate in these kinds of research studies. Having this database has made our research efforts much more efficient, allowing us to spin up studies quickly when we're in need of quick insights. In this video, I'm going to share with you how to set up your own research participant database so you can be efficient with your recruiting as well. First, choose the right tool for you. Enterprise software tools like Excel, SharePoint, or Confluence are a great place to start because they're simple, familiar, and most people already have access to these kinds of tools. Customer records management tools are also a nice option because they're made specifically for storing customer data. These tools are great for storing participant information, but the downside is you'll have to communicate with study participants and manage a record of these communications manually outside of the tool. That's where specialized recruiting tools can bring value. Not only can you store your participant list, but they facilitate the communication with participants and automatically keep records of these interactions for future reference. So, specialized tools can streamline your process and save you time, but with that being said, they often come at a higher price tag. Once you've chosen your tool, you'll need to determine what user data you'll need for recruiting. Aim to keep your data as simple as possible because this information will need to be managed and kept up to date over time. However, be sure to capture enough to avoid the need for lengthy screeners asking the same questions over and over. Beyond basic identifying and demographic information, think about your business and decide what details would be relevant. For example, you might want to indicate which products or services they use, or how long they've been a customer. Lastly, establish governance and training processes for your team. It's best to put rules in place to ensure research participants aren't contacted too often with requests to participate in research. If necessary, it's a good idea to provide direction and training to employees if recruiting best practices are complex or require a lot of manual steps. And, as always, whenever storing personal identifying information, remember to collect and store this information with data security in mind.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on training.